Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is August 30th, 2013 at 8:02 p.m. Eastern Time. I have a very, very interesting video to show you guys, people. For those of you who haven't seen this story, right? Did life and how it start on Mars? I'm going to show you guys the story, right? But the interesting thing I have to show you guys is I think in July I upload a video to you guys, right? Showing you all something that I claim was a UFO sailing across the moon, right? That's what I claim, right? And most of you who voiced your opinion, you all agreed it was a UFO. You know, you showed 15 thumbs up, 1 thumbs down. But people, the other day my friend, I'm gonna show you all in a minute, right? But before I show you all the story on Mars, right? Let me show you guys something just to back up this story, right? Here we go. My friend here, I hope you don't mind me using this video, City Virtual Quest, uploaded this video July 6, 2013, right? He said, an old flame uploaded for the purpose of sharing the imagery with an old friend at another site. Okay, he shared this video with me, people, and this is supposed to be an old video, he said. And I said, wow, brother, at 1:26 you have a very interesting image moving in front of the orb. I had that very same image moving across the moon, but yours is more clear. Mine was at night, but it is clearly the same image. Here's the title to my video: live video of UFO sailing across the moon, July 4, 2013, Anunnaki ship. So people, I uploaded my video, I think around July 5th. He uploaded his video July 6th. And people, look at his video. Look at the image on his video, right? You could clearly see here a dark object. You know what I'm saying? It looked like, I don't know, people who watched it, obviously, 4 thumbs up to 2 thumbs down, 130 views. Obviously, they didn't think much about it, but people, how is it coincidental that he have this video here, right? And on July 5th, I'll upload this video about UFO sailing across the moon. People, let me show you a little bit the image, right? Before I show you all the story from Mars, let me show you all a little bit of the image. Then I'm going to come back and show you all the rest of this. Talk about this some more, okay? This is the image. Look at it sailing across the moon. Look at that, people. The very same image right here. That's the exact same image, people. So unless this guy here faked his image, which I don't see how he could, I don't know, unless he faked his image, let's look at it again. That's what he's doing to it. Look at it. Look at that. Okay, so he put it in different shades, whatever you call it. And look at the image he gets, right? So look at his image, and mine, which you all see, is real, because mine is moving, okay? Mine is moving. See? So now let me show y'all the CNN story about life and Mars. Then I'll come back and talk about that some more. Very interesting.
Our third story out front. They say men are from Mars and women are from Venus. But is it possible we're all from Mars? An internationally acclaimed geochemist caused a stir last night when he said, quote, "The evidence seems to be building that we are actually all Martians, that life started on Mars and came to Earth on a rock." Is this science fiction or is there truth to this theory? Out front tonight, Bill Nye, the science guy. He is the executive director of the Planetary Society and here to help us sort it out. Well, this definitely sounds bizarre, but apparently you think this is a legitimate theory.
Oh yeah, oh, it's absolutely a legitimate theory. You see, we find meteorites land on the Earth's surface that are clearly from Mars. There's ways to do this. You look at the impact pattern on the rock, and you get these bubbles of gas from the Martian atmosphere. Because we find amino acids in meteorites, people have wondered, because these amino acids survive in deep space for centuries, for millennia. People have wondered for several years, a couple decades, if it's possible that life started on Mars when Mars was very wet and ended up here on Earth and we were all descendants of some Martian microbe. It sounds, I mean, I'm the first to say it sounds just extraordinary and almost crazy, but it's quite reasonable.
If science now shows that our lives started on Mars, this would be a pretty significant development, wouldn't it?
It would utterly change the world. It would change the world the way Copernicus changed the world when we found out the Earth goes around the Sun instead of the other way around. It would change the world when Galileo discovered that there are moons around another planet. It changes everything.
If he's right, are we all Martians?
It's very reasonable. I mean, it's very reasonable. But if he's right about the chemical process, that doesn't necessarily mean that we started on Mars, but it means that it's reasonable that maybe life started on Mars. Man, if we could go somewhere near the equator of Mars on a summer Mars day and look at some slushy, super salty ice and find molybdenum dioxide-enabled Martian microbes, it would change the world. And there's one way to make sure you never find them.
What's
that? And that's to not go looking. It's so inexpensive, everybody. I'm telling you, this is a worthy pursuit.
Bill Nye, the science guy, thanks so much.
So people, you all heard what the scientists say? It is inexpensive for them to go to Mars to find out the truth. But nobody wanted to go looking. People, why wouldn't they want to go looking? You know why? Because it's the greatest secret they want to keep from us. Okay? That some people here on Earth amongst us are aliens. Not all of us are. But some of them are. Okay? I ain't calling no names, but some of them are. They don't belong here on Earth. But anyway, the point is, people, we all know that according to Stitching, the Anunnaki had a base on Mars. Okay? Marduk ran that base on Mars. Okay? So, don't think that the Anunnaki just disappeared out of creation like that. If they were there once, they're still around. So, the point is, we all know that those of us who are intelligent know that we're not alone in the universe. And the point that my friend City here, he has this video about with the same image, right? The same image as I have in my video. So it must be a spaceship. Okay, it obviously, I don't think it's a satellite or man-made, because look at that. Look at his image. Now, look at my image. And I'm going to show you another image, people. And I'll show you another image that looks like the same figure in front of the moon that I took also. So why won't they go to Mars, right, to find out the truth that who among us are the Martians and who among us are from Venus and who among us are from Earth? Because it's in my belief, people, it's my belief that humans don't belong on planet Earth. I believe in my heart that we came here, that we are the invaders, that this is the planet of animals, The Planet of the Apes. The apes was God of this planet. That's my belief. Okay, and we invaded their planet. I don't think there was ever any evil on Earth. Nah, there was never any evil on Earth. There were no animals eating each other. Those are the aliens that came here, the flesh eaters. The flesh eaters are the invaders. That's what I believe. The hunters. They brought the hunters to Earth to hunt in the sea, to hunt in the air, and to hunt on land, to hunt in the holes and in the caves, to hunt all over, to hunt and kill. Why? I don't know. Maybe the planet was being overpopulated by because there was so much peace. And maybe, I don't know, it could be a divine intervention. But the hunters are overkilling. So if it was for a divine purpose, because maybe Earth was so peaceful and the planet was being overpopulated, and they knew that sooner or later it would be so overgrown that it wouldn't be enough food to feed. So they brought in the hunters to hunt. That's my, and I'm just putting my little 2 cents in it. You know, you all know I like to talk and try to make sense of the nonsense. But if it was a divine intervention, then the hunters are overkilling. It's time to stop the blood clot killing and the blood shedding. So now let me show you all another image. I took a photo of the moon. Bear with me a second. Okay, now people, keep this image in mind, okay? Keep this image in mind and keep the one I showed you all that I uploaded at the moon in mind, okay? Keep those in mind, okay? Then look at this image here I'm about to show you guys. This is a photo I took a few years ago, right? Look at this image, and people, I was pointing the camera at the moon. At the moon, I was pointing the camera. Look at the same image, only that it's bigger. I'm gonna show it to you blown up, okay? I'm just showing you the raw video that I took. You can see the white thing there. That's supposed to be the moon, shaped like an arm. And you see the reflection here, and like a face, a triangle, a pyramid. Let me show it to you guys enlarged. This is the image, people. You can clearly here, look at the top of the head. Shaped like the triangle, just like the one in my video and in CT's video. You see triangle, then you see the arm like it's sailing across, it's sailing in the sky. But most of all, look at the eyes. Yet eyes look to me look like eyes, right? You have eyes in the front and eyes on the side. And if that's the case, then you have eyes in the back also. Your Bible talk about the whatever it is with the four faces. Anyway, the point being, this thing is sailing across the moon. Okay, it's not a cloud, because look at its outline, like a white person. Okay. I'm not, it's not a racial remark, okay? I'm just talking about, look at their hair. Look at how their hair is. And it looks like the God that they have in the Bible. You know how they have that drawing of the white man, the bearded white man? And they say he's God? That's what I meant. The drawing that they have showing this bearded white man in the sky. This looks like him, right? And he's sailing across the moon. So now compare that image. See it? And look at the moon, people. Look at this thing shaped like a skeleton arm. Okay, and a reflection right here. But look at it. And people, you know something? You know when I took the photo, I actually saw it. I actually saw the light bounce. Okay, I actually saw the light bounce back into my face. When I took the camera, the light bounced back from whatever it is, it hit in the sky and bounced right back into my face. Okay? I used my camera flash and the thing bounced right back in my face and flashed almost like a bright light hit me in my face. No BS. And that's the image came. When I saw it, I was horrified. I'm like, what the heck is that? So, anyway, If you look at that and compare it with this image, look at it. Look at it. I mean, it's not actually, obviously not going to be the same because mine's are taken in the darkness. His is in the light. But the point is, the similarities are there for all to see, for all want to see it. And in my video, I was talking about the bracelet on my leg. And let me show you a little bit of what I was saying. And you see the UFO appear while I'm talking mess. Here we go.
I didn't know the bracelet came out, people. But my feet got caught to something. And it yanked the bracelet off, and I didn't know. It was only minutes after I looked at my leg and I realized the bracelet was missing. So they put me under house arrest. So July 4th, I was under house arrest from July 3rd to the 5th. The 5th, I went and they gave me a new strap and a bracelet.
So people, addressing the people, but I was pointing the camera at the moon and speaking. Now when I was speaking about how they have this bracelet on my leg and how it's malfunctioning, that thing crossed the moon. So it is quite possible that some life didn't begin here on Earth. They began on Mars. If not Mars, they surely began on another planet, on Earth. What a planet of the animals. We are the invaders, the meat eaters. We are the hunters. Time to stop the hunting. Time to stop the killing. Time to stop the bloodthirstiness. Obama, stop the military strikes in Syria. Syria, stop gassing your own people. Or maybe it's American propaganda doing it for an excuse to bomb Syria. See, I don't trust Obama no more. I don't trust America foreign politics anymore. Okay? They're deceiving, so I don't trust none of them. You know what I'm saying? I don't really tell the truth. Is Assad really gassing his own people? If he put gas in his own country, the gas gonna, if the air blow, it's gonna blow right back into his own people's camp. So think about that, people. If Assad is gassing his own people, the gas, there's a danger that the gas gonna blow into his own camp. So I don't know. I don't trust American war military machine. You know, these war mongers, they want war. They already drain our coffers. They already drain our coffers, but they still want more, you know? It's not enough. So they start all these wars so that they could increase the oil prices. And then they start all these wars and they tax us by increasing the oil prices so that we could pay for their war efforts. You see? Come on. Stop the blood clot, blood shedding. It's enough. Because while you all think that you all are masters of the earth, the true masters are coming. And they're going to require of you all for the blood that you shed every day. Okay? You are treating people who are not terrorists like terrorists. And you all are the real terrorists who are getting away with murder, mass murder. Okay, what y'all doing? Feeding aliens? That's what y'all doing? Feeding aliens with our flesh? Time to stop the blood clot killing. Time to stop the blood shedding. One love, my people. One love. But we don't stand up and demand that these people stop the blood clot killing and the blood shedding. They don't keep on doing it. They gotta keep deceiving us, giving us all this misinformation, taking our eyes off what's really going on. Okay, America is broke, didn't you all say? So how much billions is gonna cost for y'all to drop one bomb? One bomb in Assad's territory. When all y'all have to do is marshal an army around his camp and demand that he cease and desist. He'll do that. You all have to fire one shot. Persuasion is better than force. But no. Y'all think y'all gonna talk to people and persuade them to do things when y'all doing the same thing that y'all telling them not to do? Master army around his camp. He will not fire a shot at you guys unless he really want war. Let him fire the first shot then. Instead of spending billions to drop a bomb that gonna kill innocent people also. So you see the hypocrisy? Did Assad really gas his own people? Or did American Zionist Rothschild propaganda machine seen, yet they do not see, and hearing, yet they still do not comprehend? Because the eyes have been shut, the ears have been closed. In them, the prophecy of Isaiah has been fulfilled. One love to all my people whose eyes are open, whose heart are not dull, and whose ears hear and eyes see. One love, one destiny for humanity. Paul McLean, I'm out. I'm disgusted.